Hello everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to automate date pickers in Selenium. So normally these date pickers are customized control and we can say customized web elements, because within that date picker itself, we can see multiple elements. Like if I see these two, these are the two different date pickers. So in the first date picker, if you see, we have a labels and we have multiple text here, 9, 10, 11, 12, these are all different links, and we have arrow marks. Okay, so these are all different web elements. And if I see the second one, so here also we have some text box, and here this is one frame and another frame, so which contains multiple years and months and dates. So these are all customized controls. Okay, so the developer have designed these by using multiple based upon normal web elements. So how we can handle these date pickers? So we have to handle this date pickers in different way, because the logic will be different from one date picker to another date picker. The same logic may not work for all kinds of date pickers. Now here I'm going to show you two different examples and how we can handle these date pickers. And I will take two different type of date pickers. Okay. Now the first one, we'll see this one, and then after that we'll see the second one. So to demonstrate the first one, I'm just opening my URL. So this is my URL, phptravis.net. So in this particular URL, okay, so here when I click on this check-in, it will open up this date picker. So from this, we have to select the proper month and year, and then select the date from this, okay? Now let us see how we can automate this. So first we need to think about the logic, how we can do this. So as soon as I click on this one, first of all, it will pop up this calendar control, right? So first thing, when I do click here, it will pop up this calendar control or date picker. First, we need to check whether this is as per expected or not. So this is a current month and current year it is showing, right? So if it is exactly, this is what we are expecting. So directly we can go and jump into the date and select this. Suppose if this is not our expected, suppose in future month and future I want to select, then you have to click on this arrow mark multiple times till you get your expected month and year. As soon as you get expected month and year here, you have to stop clicking this, and then we need to go to a date and we have to select the proper date from this. Okay, so this is how we need to implement the logic. Now to do this, first of all, I'll create a new, this is my Java project and this is my Eclipse. I already have one Java project here, and I'm going to create a new package. I will name this as date pickers and then click on the finish. Now I'll create a new class. I will name it as date picker demo one, and then take this main method, then finish. I'm just creating normal test case. And then here, first of all, we have to specify two different variables. One is string month is equal to, I'm just taking one month is equal to, I'll just say I want to select something called March. Okay, I want to select March and 2019. Okay, this is my expected, but what it is there here directly. So here we have this particular one. Okay, so as soon as I click on this, by default it will open in the new one. So the current month and date. So when I click on this, by default it will open current month and year. Okay, so but what my expecting is, I am expecting March 2019. So I need to navigate till I get the March 2019. So what should we do is, first of all, let me write a small piece of code here to get, and date also we can store in some variable. Let's say string day is equal to, and I want to select March 2019 and 20th I want to select. Okay, and then just write normal code like how we can launch the browser and everything. So this is my piece of code I have written, system.set property, and this is a key value webdriver.chrome.driver and a location of my driver, and then create webdriver, import this webdriver, and then I'm using Chrome browser, and then I'm launching my application. So as soon as I launch my application, first thing we have to perform on the click action on this particular check-in, right? So let's identify this. So now just I'm identifying this check-in, and let's see the HTML code for this. Just a second, let me open this page one more time. Okay. So first of all, I need to identify this check-in box. So inspect this check-in. And now you can see here some name is available, check-in, right? So the name is a check-in. And we need to properly capture this one. And if you see the XPath for this, copy XPath for this. And this is our XPath. Okay, this is our XPath, we got it. So we need to perform click action on this, and then we'll get the calendar control. So let's try this. So driver dot find element by dot XPath, and specify the XPath here. So here we need to specify the XPath and then dot click. So this action will perform the click on the particular element, and then let us execute till here, run as Java application, and then it will launch the web page, and now it will clicking on the date picker. So okay, now it is launching. Now I got the URL, and now it should click on check-in process. So yes, now it is click on the check-in. So as soon as you click on the check-in, we need to check this text, January 2019 to the current one. And if it is your expected, still fine. We can directly jump into the date. But if it's still not expected, we have to click on this right arrow key multiple times till you get the expected month in year. So the next step is we have to here I'll put some time after clicking on this thread.asleep, and I'll put some time like 2000 milliseconds, and then add this exception. And after that, we have to write one while loop, because we need to click on this multiple times, right? We have to click on this multiple times. So this arrow key, we have to click on multiple times. So when I click on this arrow key, we have to click on multiple times. So to click on this, before clicking this, we need to extract this value. Okay, and check this value is expected or not. If it is not expected, then we have to click on multiple times. So before, but these two things we have to do repeatedly. Okay, click this arrow mark, capture this, and check it is expected or not. If it is not, again click on the arrow mark, again capture the text and check it is expected or not. So these two things we need to repeat multiple times till we get the exact month and year. Okay, so how we can capture the text from this? So inspect this element. Okay, and here this is the element. We have to capture the text from this. Let me just capture the XPath from this. And driver dot find element by dot XPath, and here specify that XPath. So this is an XPath of the text, and from this we need to extract the text value. So let's say dot get text, dot get text. So the get text method will extract the value, and I'll store that into a string variable of a string test. So before that, we need to repeat these steps multiple times, right? So I need to write one while loop here. I'll put certain condition called as a true. So every time this loop will becomes true only, but as soon as we found that exact month and year, we will come out exit from this while loop by using break command. Okay, so until unless this condition keep on becomes true. So now I have captured the text value from this particular date picker, and then I want to verify whether this is my expected or not. So what I can do is immediately I can just check within the loop. It's we have to write one condition here. If and text dot equals test dot equals, and we stored this our expected month and year here, right? So we have to put this variable here. So text dot equals and month, and then in this condition, okay, if this text is equal to our month, right, this is expected, then what should do, we have to exit from this while loop immediately. So I'll use a break command here. Okay, this break command immediately will exit from the if condition as well as while loop, because here we found the expected month and year from the date picker. Suppose if the condition is not true, okay, and then I have to repeat, and then I have to click on this arrow mark. So if you see here, if it is not as per expected, then we have to click on this arrow mark multiple times. Let's inspect this arrow mark, and this is the next arrow mark, then copy the XPath, go here. And in else block, we will write that one. So identify this driver dot find element by dot XPath, and specify this XPath dot click. So this we have to do multiple times. Okay, so this click we have to do multiple times. And when you click on the arrow mark again, we go up and condition again will be, become true. It will capture the again text, month and date, a month and year. Again, it will check that it is ever expected or not. If it is expected, then it will come out from the while loop, or still it will repeat till we got the expected month and year. Okay. So once it is exited from the while loop, by that time, this condition will become true. Otherwise, it will go keep on go and get the month and year until we get the expected. So once we come out from this while loop, we found the expected month and year. And then we have to directly jump into this table and we have to find the date, expected date. So how we can find this date? Now here, let us identify one of this date and let's see the XPath for this. And I'm using here, CrowPath is there, right? So let's go and use this CrowPath. And I find something here. Okay, now this is giving something here. This is an XPath it is giving. So if you notice this one, this is basically a table, okay? So here tbody1, tr3, td4, okay? So what I can do is, I'll just take only this particular portion and just identify this. What this is, tr3 slash td and 4, right? So this is the actual XPath. Let's copy this once again, put it here. Okay, now it is able to point 13, right? And that means table data 4. When I say 5 here, and it will point to the 14, something like this. So what I want to do here is, I want to write my customized XPath. Okay, so till T body, everything fine. But here, TR1 is TR of 3 representing the row, 5 representing the column. So what I want to do is, I will just write one generic XPath like this. So just, I don't specify any TR, just say TR. And then press enter. What it is saying, it is selecting TD, means table data. That means 5 is saying, 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th column. And the 5th column it is saying, okay, 5th column it is completely selected. So when I remove that row number, okay, from all the rows, 5th column is selected. Similarly, if I remove the 5 here, okay, so if I remove this bracket also, and then what happens? This XPath is selected all the nodes from this date picker. Okay. So now what I want to do is, I will use this XPath and I will capture all these elements and check wherever I have the expected date. I'll directly go there and select that date. Okay. Now I'm using this expected. This is a customized XPath I'm getting used here. Then identify this driver dot find element by dot XPath and specify this XPath. And here I will verify something, because I need to go and click on that element, means we need to select the date here, right? So here in the TD, okay, so here I will use one method called contains. Still XPath is not completed because we need to select the proper date, expected date. So within the contains, I will use one more method called text method, okay, contains of text, of text, contains of text, and I want to just hold on. So contains of text comma, and here I will specify some date. So for now I'll just say only 20. I'm hard coding this value and close this bracket, text bracket and one square bracket, quotations, and then one more bracket. Okay, so what this will do is, this particular XPath, right? So till here it is matching all the buttons 1 to 31. And in 1 to 31, whichever is having 20 is a value, that will be selected by this XPath. Okay. So if you want, you can verify this one more time. So let me just copy this one and again to the CrowPath. And for now, you can see it is exactly selected 20 here. So contains text comma 20 I have provided. It is exactly selected the 20. Suppose when I say 15 here and it is selected 15 here. Okay. So this is a customized XPath I have to use to select the proper date from this list. So let's go and use it. So go to Eclipse and here the same XPath I mentioned here. Same XPath. Okay. And here if you say double quotations, we have to use slashes. If you use single quotations, we no need to use the slashes. For now, I'm hard coding the date. Later I'll pass customized one. Okay. So this is an XPath. Okay. So this will exactly select the date, and what I have to do again, we have to perform the click action on this, right? So immediately I will do dot click. So this will exactly go and click on the date. Now let us see how it will do. So let me run the code now. Okay, we have almost done. So run as Java application. Okay, now my page is launching. All right, so now I'm maximizing the page. Now you can observe here. So here I just first click on this check-in. Yes. Now, yes, now it is go to. See, now it is again go to the next one. Okay, this is the next date picker. That is for departure date. But the date exactly it is selected here. 15th March I have given. So March 15th I have given. So March 2019, sorry, 20 here. But here I have hardcoded the date, right? So 15. So that's the reason it is taken 15. But now I want to parameterize this value. Within the XPath, I want to pass my dynamic value instead of hardcoding this. So what I can do is, I have initialized this variable day in the initial level, right? I want to pass this value. So to do this, I have to just go here and instead of 15, okay, and just remove this value and just say day here. But we cannot directly substitute the value in XPath directly. So we have to follow certain syntax. So just one add one plus here after that variable and keep everything in the double quotations like this. Okay, so this is a syntax of passing the parameter to the XPath. So now whatever date we have selected here, day, and that day will be selected from this date picker control. Now save it and let me run one more time as a Java application. All right, so now it is launching my page. Now you can see here, I'm maximizing this. Okay, now here it is clicking on check-in. Now it is selected, it is selecting, I have given 20, right? So now it is selected exactly March 20th. Okay, so this is how we can just automate the date picker. So the same logic may not work for other date pickers. Okay, this is logic is relevant to only this particular date picker. All right, so this is how we can automate the date pickers. Now sometimes we'll see different kind of date pickers. So this logic is works for only this kind of date pickers. Suppose now I'm showing you another kind of date picker. So it will be like this. Okay, so January 2019 and February 2019. So here we don't have any arrow marks. Okay, here this is arrow mark, we have to keep on clicking on and we have to extract this January 2019 or not, this is expected or not, and then we need to go to date and select this date. But sometimes we need to write the different logic for this. And to demonstrate this, I'll use another URL, and this I have captured from Expedia.ca website. Let me open this one. This is my website. Okay, so from this, okay, right, so this is my element, this is my date picker here. So when I click on this check-in, and it will open date picker like this. Now I need to select the proper month and year along with the date here. Okay, now let us see how we can do this. So the same logic we have to apply here, but slightly we have to change here, because at a time it is showing 2 months and dates, right? So two frames it is showing. So this is a different logic we have to apply. Now I'll show you how we can handle this date picker. So to do this, I'm just going to create one more example. Let's create a date picker demo 2. Let's create a new class. I will name it as date picker 2. Date picker demo 2. Okay, then finish it. So I haven't created main method. So let me create main method also. So within the classes, let's say create a main method, right? So now here, I have to write the logic. Let's see how we can handle this kind of date pickers. So as a first step, what we have to do is, just hold on. Okay, just hold on guys. All right, so now we can see another date picker, how we can handle. So this is my website, right? So this is my website. I'm going to automate this date picker. Now let us start writing the code here. So the first thing is we have to create the system.set property and a driver object, and I need to open the URL of application, right? So let me open this system.set property and then created the web driver object, import this Chrome driver, and then open this URL. So as soon as I open the URL, what is the first action I have to do is, let me close this win. Okay, so this is an application, not this one. And we have to automate this one. So as soon as first we need to click on this element. Okay, first time when you open your web page, it will be like this. And we have to click on this check-in box, and then you will get this calendar, right? So let us identify this element. So inspect, and let's go to HTML. Okay, so you can also use GrowPath to get the proper XPath. Okay, now this is an XPath I captured. So let me use this XPath here. Driver dot find element by dot XPath, and specify this XPath, and dot click action we have to perform. So this will open up the calendar control, and let's create two different variables. So string month is equal to I'm expecting March 2019 should be selected, and the date, so string expected underscore date is equal to I want to select 15. Okay, so this is my requirement. This day, month, year, and date I want to select from the date picker. All right. So now we need to write the logic. Again, we have to write the same logic. So first of all, what I have to do is, as soon as I click on this, first we need to check. So here we need to understand one more thing is, Jan 2019 is currently highlighting the month. Okay, this is not highlighting. When you click on this arrow mark, again, February 19 will come into the first box. Again, if you click on the arrow mark, March 2019 will come to the first box. Okay, like this, it will go on. So what we have to do is, first thing, we as soon as we open the date picker, currently it will focus on the current month. So this particular frame, not the second frame. Okay, so now we need to capture this one, Jan 2009. And then we will verify whether this is our expected month and year or not. If it is expected, directly go to the date and select. If it is not expected, then again we have to click on this arrow mark multiple times till we get the actual expected month and year. Okay, so after clicking on this, I will write one while loop just like this. While I'll make this condition again is true, and in this condition, the first of all I need to capture this one, inspect this element Jan 2019, and this is a XPath it is exactly giving. So we need to again customize this XPath. So currently what this XPath is pointing out only January 2019. Suppose when I change my date again, if I say same XPath here, it will not match. Okay, so we have to write the generic XPath which will always match with this text value, right? So to do this, what I can do is here I'll just remove this part, contains part. Okay, just use only till caption, and then press enter. Now we can see it is matching this one as well as this one. If you go back also, caption will work here. So / caption is a XPath which will match with the both the captions. Okay, so here we need to write a generic XPath. So from this capture, so we have to extract the value. When I say get text, once you identify this element, when you use get text method, it will capture the month and year. So whichever is currently first highlighting, not the second one, whichever is highlighting the first one, which will be getting. Now let us try this first, and in the loop statement, I will write, and before that, let us, instead of writing while loop directly, I'll try to show you which one we will get from the date picker. So here I'll just say driver dot find element by dot XPath, and specify the only the caption. Use the dot get text method. Okay, and let us see what this will print. I'll just create one variable called text here, and I will just create a variable called as a text here, and just I have print this value. Okay, let us see what this will capture, because the caption XPath is matching the two captions, right? So which one we will get? Print ln. I'll just print the text value here and then execute this and see. put the semicolon, and now I'm running as Java application. Alright, so now my page is launching. This is my page. Now keenly observe here. So captions will match both the elements. Just I'm maximizing this page. Okay, then it will perform click action on the check-in. So once you click on the check-in option, then we'll extract that value, month and date. Okay, now it is clicked on this, and now go to code and see. Now it is written Jan 2019. But what we have seen here is this XPath is exactly matching with the two elements here. So in the crow path, when I test, these two matching elements are there. But even though we have two matching elements, it is retaining the first element. Okay, this is what we are expecting. Okay, so this is a currently enabled and second part is a currently disabled. So it is extracted single value. So now our job is very simple. So what we have to do is we keep this statement inside the while loop. Okay, because every time we have to capture that and check whether this is expected month or year. So now we need to write one condition statement. I'll just say if, same logic whatever we have created previously. Okay, and here I need to verify test2.equals, I'll just say month. So what this is month, month is our expected month, and whatever captured text is equal to our month. And then what we have to do is we need to immediately come out from the conditional statement and a looping statement. We no need to go and keep on clicking on this arrow mark. Not required. If this is not matching, this is not ever expected, then you have to click on this arrow mark. That should be put in the else block. Now I'll identify this arrow mark, and this is basically a button, right? So I will identify this, and I will use this XPath, direct XPath it is giving, and in the else block I'll write driver dot find element by dot XPath and specify that XPath dot click action. So this will keep on clicking on the arrow mark. So once it is click on this, again it will go up and condition is true, and again capture the text, verify whether this is expected month or not. If it is expected, then come out from the loop, or else again it will clicking on the arrow mark. So this will repeat multiple times till we get the expected month and year. So by the time we exit from this while loop, so it will, by default, it will automatically select. So we use break command here, right? So break means as soon as it is matched, then it will come out from the while loop immediately. So once it is come out from the while loop, we have to immediately select the date from this list. Okay, so now I'll show you how to select the date from this list. So basically this is also a table. Okay, the problem here is we cannot get this data just like a previous example. And if you see this one, so this is an XPath for the 9. I'm just highlighting the 9. Okay, so this is an XPath. So every time this will change. So for example, when you put this in XPath here, it is coming 9, right? So when I say button 1, so when I say button 2, there is no element. So button 1 is manually required. Currently it is selecting 9. Okay, so here TR and T4, TD, 2 and 4 is representing the row and column. Row and column. So the data is present inside the row and column, and the data is present on top of the button. Okay, this is basically buttons. Okay, these are not links, these are basically buttons. So but actually this button 1 means on the TR row and fourth column, and 9 is present in the second row and the third fourth column. So if I see SMTW, this is the fourth column. And TR2 is representing the second row. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is the first row. 6, 7, 8, 9 is the second row. Okay. So if you want to point this particular day, we have to say proper row and a proper column value. Both we have to specify. Okay. So what I can do is, instead of reading all the data and everything, I can just capture all the buttons, text values. And then I will write one conditional statement, whichever is matching with some date, and select that one. So I will just capture this XPath, and then I will write one more for loop is required here. Okay, I'll write one for loop here. That is before writing this for loop, I have to extract all the 1 to 31. So whatever values we have in this calendar, I want to extract them. So driver dot, and this time I'll use a find elements method. find elements. And how we can capture all these values with this XPath? So just remove these 2 and 4, okay? Because when I say 2 and 4, it is exactly pointing to specific element. Now, if I remove these 2, okay, and also 4, and this becomes, it is selected all these values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and everything, right? So now this is a customized XPath I have to use. Copy this XPath and find elements, because we are getting multiple elements here. So find elements, driver dot by dot XPath. By dot XPath, and specify the complete XPath here. Okay, then semicolon. So what this command will return is, it will return multiple web elements. So we have to store all the dates. So I'll just create one variable called all dates, and inside this variable I stored all the date web elements. And what kind of variable it should be? It should be list type, and in the Angular basis we have to say web element, because every element is a, every item is a web element, and it is holding multiple objects, so that we have to say list type. Now from this all dates, so now all dates contains 1 to 31, so we have to read each and every web element, and then whichever is matching our expected date, we have to select that one. And to do this, so list we have to import from java.util package. Okay, java.util. All right, so now I'll write one for loop to read the values, or read the element, each and every element from this variable. Okay, so let me write a for each loop. This is very simple to read the list. So I'll just specify variable all dates. I want to read each and every web element, and here create one web element, and I'll just say ELE, some element. Okay, and inside this for loop, so now what happens is, from all the dates there are multiple web elements are there, each and every web element will be stored in the ELE. Okay, so from this ELE we have to extract the text one, get text. Okay, from this element we have to extract the get text. So let us see what this will print first of all. Okay, because this text contains two values, we need only one value, that is a date only. So here I'll just say I will print, this is element, right? So system dot out dot println of element dot get text. Okay, so now let us see what this will print exactly. So it will print exactly date along with the month, because it is returning the two values, but we don't need month. Okay, we need only date. So it is opening the page now. Let us see. Okay, so now it is launching my page, and after that it will click on check-in. So once you click on the check-in, as I said, March 15th something, right? So that will be selected month. So still page is loading. Okay, now the date. So now you can see here, March 29th is selected. Still it is going on. So September 20, still keep on going. So because something is not matched. So let us see what it is not matched. What is saying here is, application enable browser content, something is saying. So let us see, the logic is incorrect. So I'll say it March 2019 and 15. And here I'm capturing the text from the caption and storing that into text, and I'm checking whether the text is equal to month or not. If it is equal, I'm coming out from this. And if it is not equal, then I need to go and click on this button multiple times. Okay. And same thing I have done here, but somehow it is not going. Let me run one more time. Okay, I think yeah, this is a exact issue actually. So there is no March here. When I see only 3 characters we have, right? But I have said here complete value. So just put this only MAR. This is the mistake we have done. Okay, so now let me run this as a Java application. Okay, so now again it is launching my browser and opening this URL, and just notice what this will return. Okay, now it is clicking on check-in. Take some time. All right, so now it is clicked on the calendar date picker. Now you can see here March 2019 it's went. Okay, March 2019. Now we can see the output here, what it is saying, but the calendar, from the calendar March 2019 till it is reached. And after this, in 2019, there are multi 1 to 31 days are there, right? So it should read only the date part, but it is also reading the month also, like March 1, March 2, March 3, March 4, something like this. Okay. So the getText method here is returning two values. Okay. So March and 1, we have to separate these two. We have to separate March and 1. Okay. So how we can separate them is, so when I see this one, when I see the HTML, just inspect one of this element. So when, for this particular element, you will see two different properties in HTML. So when I inspect this exact date, okay, this is a button. When you expand this, so here this is a March and this is a 8. So it is combinedly giving this data, and March is printing in first line, 8 is comes under the next line. So these two inputs are, these two data, whatever we have captured by using getText, is printing in two different lines. Okay. So this is very, very important one. So little challenging, we have to separate these two values. So to separate these two values, we have to use a split method. And again, how these two values are aligned in the next line. So the date is comes under the next line. March is the first value, 1 is the second value. And these two values are separated by using next line. So here we have to use one method called a split method. Okay, by using split method, we can separate these two values, because getText method is giving two values here. So to do this, instead of printing this, what I will do is I will just create one string variable and store this data. We'll say date underscore text is equal to. Now currently this date underscore text contains two values, March and 1. So I want to separate these two. How to separate? We want to separate this. We have a method called date text dot split, where we have to split wherever the next line appears. That means slash n is representing the next line. This is a regular expression. Now what this command will do is, this method will split this value in two different parts, March and 1. So once it is splitted into two values, we have to store them into single variable. So now we have to create one array, string array type of variable, string date array. So because array can hold multiple values, so here it is splitted these two values as a two strings. Now date of 0, it is stored the first value. In date of 1, it will store the second value. So what value we have to we should require now? Date of 1 value we require. The first one is we don't require, because we have to select the date, not month. So now the date array contains the two values, one is March and the other one is 1. So the second value we have to represent here. So because this is the array, right? So array index will start from 0. So when I say March, March is available in the date of 0, and 1 is available inside the date of 1, because these values are split into two parts based upon the next line. Okay. Now we have to refer date of 1. So that is exactly pointing to this value. All right. So now I capture the date, and this contains the two values now. We have to get the actual value. So now write why the condition, if date of 1, so that means we will get the date, right? 1 equals to equals, and what our expected date. So this is our expected date, right? So copy this and put it here. If expected date and actual date both are right, then what we should do is, we have to click on this element. Which element? The same element, capture this ELE dot click, and this will exactly select the date from date picker. Okay, so ELE, and we have to close something here. Okay, another next micro. So ELE dot, we have to perform click action. So this will exactly select the date, and after clicking on this, immediately again we have to come out, right? So we no need to go for the next date, because it will give you all the dates 1 to 31. So as soon as we found exact date, expected date, immediately we have to click on the date, immediately come out from the if condition as well as one from for loop. Okay. So let me just repeat the logic once again. So what we have done is in the first while loop, we have repeated this thing. So till we get the expected month. As soon as we got the expected month here, we stop repeating the while loop. So this loop is repeating that one. So as soon as we found the expected month here, we are coming out from while loop. And the next for loop is getting the all the dates from 1 to 31. And here we are verifying expected date and actual date is equal or not. And then as soon as we found our expected date, immediately we are clicking on the date and we are coming out from if condition as well as for loop. And here when I use element.getText method, it is giving month along with the date both. But we need only date part. So that's the reason I have used split method to separate the date part from the month and extract the date in day of one, because day of zero contains a month value, that is March, and day of one contains a 1, 2, 3, 4, something like this. So that value is equal to expected date. Then clicking on the element, it will select the exact date. Okay. Now let me execute. This is how we need to write the code. Now currently March 2019, I have selected 15th is my date. Let me change this date. I'll say 25 March. March 2019, 25, it should select. Now run as Java application. Now this time we will see March 2019, 25, it will select. So now I'm maximizing my page. So now you can see it will navigate till March 2019. This is the first thing will happen. Okay, so now it is opening the web page. Now you can see here it is navigating February 2019, next March 2019. Now it is stopped, then it should select 25. Exactly, it is selected 25 from the March. Okay, so this is how we can just navigate through the date picker, and we have to write logic such a way. Okay, and then we can select the proper month, year and the date. So this is another example to get the to select the date and month from the date pickers. And these logics are not constant. Some this logic is works only with this kind of date picker. So if you find some other date pickers, the logic may be changed, because this is a customized element. The same code may not work for all kinds of web elements. Okay guys, so that's all for this video guys. So please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.